A jsme tady.
Wow,
ty král.
Welcome to Old Trafford, guys. Rows 15 and 16 there, thank you. Move all the way down, guys, for me. Rows 15 and 16, thank you very much.
Protože mám jeden volný lístek od zákazníka, takže se sem půjde na další sezónu na Mourinha.
Welcome to Old Trafford. Is it anybody's first time here today?
Yep.
Anyone been before?
Splendid.
And of course, the main question is, are we all United fans?
Yeah. Yes.
Who's not? Manchester United fan, there's always one. Or two, as we can see in the back. What's your team?
Liverpool.
I'm sorry?
Liverpool.
What's your team as well?
Arsenal.
Arsenal? What are you guys doing here?
I love
You love English football. Well, you're very welcome, whatever team you support. You're going to have fun on this tour today. Not as much fun as we're going to have. But still. Anyway, you're sat in the biggest club stadium in British football, guys. Very nearly 75,500 seats in this stadium. Makes it by far the biggest. The next one down from us is Arsenal's Emirates Stadium, which is 60,000.
Wembley's obviously
the biggest in the country, but in terms of privately owned football stadiums just used by one club, Manchester United is the biggest in Britain. You sat in the Sir Alex Ferguson stand, 25,000 seats in this one stand here. It's got three tiers to it. It was built in time for England to host Euro 96 games, and it was renamed, formerly the North Stand, but renamed the Sir Alex Ferguson stand to commemorate 25 years in charge of United by Sir Alex Ferguson. Looking round to the left, guys, that's our east stand. In the old days, it was called the scoreboard end, because we only had one scoreboard in the old days, and that's the end it was in. Nowadays, we've got four scoreboards, so wherever you are, you can see at least one of those black screens there. All they do, though, is show the scores. There's no action replays in the stadium at all. If you had that, you'd need bigger scoreboards. We'd lose seats, so that's why they don't exist here. Opposite us is the newly renamed Sir Bobby Charlton stand. That was renamed in April to commemorate 60 years of involvement with Manchester United by Sir Bobby Charlton, obviously player, ambassador, director, been here a very long time. So that was renamed in April. There you can see the players tunnel in the corner before the West Stand, or more famously known, the Stretford End. Anybody know why it's called the Stretford End? Can anybody guess the town in Manchester next that's that way? Stretford, correct. That's why it's called the Stretford End. And that's where the hardcore United fans sit. That's where all the singing starts on a match day and then filters its way around the stadium. So on the tour today, guys, we're going to start off by the disabled platform down there where you can see that manunited.com sign. That is the best place for photographs because you get to see this side of the stadium from down there, which looks really, really impressive. We'll talk to you about our disabled facilities as well. We'll let you know what's going on with the pitch. Obviously, you can see at the moment we're doing a lot of work on the pitch. So we'll talk to you about our pitch when we get down there as well. We'll talk about our disabled facilities, as I say, before moving upstairs to the press.
Tak, takhle to vypadá uvnitř stadionu. Podíváme se do šaten a úplně všude.
So as soon as I see Darren, we'll start making friends.
There he is.
So the head to Mr. Alex Ferguson is now this way, heading towards the east. Players looking forward to Australia's services as well. Then on the left hand side, stage, the portrait of Sir Alex Ferguson, the best one. Looks like you from a distance, we get closer, have a good look, very tactically made. Looks like you from there, get closer, starts getting blurry. It's made by Kington Street. Impressive. Here's where I got a photo of Sir Alex Ferguson with 9 different trophies. These are 9 different trophies he won whilst manager of Manchester United. In total, he won 38 trophies in 26 and a half years. Obviously a very, very successful man. It's good to see that trophy back in the museum as well. I missed it this morning. Is that explained yet?
No. Tak jdeme dál. Oni tady trošku bazénem. Rooneyho špinavý hráty. Hele, Bervin fan Robin. Něco pro Petra Nováka. Zdravím, Peters. Půjdeme se na fotbálek spolu. Zvu tě. Tak, a máme to tady napálený jako kráva. Yeah. Si stěžovali, že máte drahý popcorn v kině, tak si běžte zahrabat. Procházím dál. Jdeme na místo do rohu stadionu, kde je nejhezčí výhled na celý stadion. Tam odsaď se všechno fotí. Pozápasový rozhovory.
Everything in this area is all catered for anyone in a wheelchair. You have the ability suite just through there. It's laid out like the rest of the concourse area. So you see the kiosks that we see all around the stadium, but they're all very low lying. So anyone in a wheelchair has to take care of themselves behind that door if they wish. Here's where you see some photos from our Disabled Supporters Association, the WUDSA, Manchester United Disabled Supporters Association. And the photos, these are from fundraising events which will take place throughout the year. Players do some of these events help raise more money for the charity that way. There's some great players United past and present up on the board though. We've got Ronaldo, there he is, Eric Cantona, Georgie Best, Sir Alex Ferguson, Tommy Charlton, Beckham, Scholes. There's a lot of great players up on the board here. Not too many modern players though, because the last few photos were taken in 2009. So Wayne Rooney, he does feature. The young Wayne Rooney, he tells the young Wayne Rooney to still have his natural hairline. The one area of the stadium you don't want to visit, just to the left behind, so yeah, the police station. Directly below the away fans.
Tady to má vlastní policejní stanici s vlastníma celama. Pro chlapy, pro ženský. Takže, když tady děláte bordel, tak vás tady rovnou zavřou. Ten pocit je trošičku nezapomenutelný tady. Nevím, jestli bych dokázal hrát před tolika lidma.
space on the US.
Single picture of a tractor.
Čau, já jsem Michal, docela dobře hraju FIFU, nechcete mě draftovat? Si beru tuhle sedačku, 25, že jsem seděl v tomhle rohu. Sedačky.
So when you're ready, follow on this way, we're going to head up to the press room. Find a seat, guys. Welcome to our press theatre.
Thank you.
Wow. Here you come. Come and find a seat. Welcome to the press theatre, guys. Come and find a seat. Welcome to the press theatre, guys. Come and find a seat. This is where the Manchester United hold their post-match press conferences. So this is where the managers are interviewed by members of the media. Now it's normally the written press in here. So essentially, if you read about Manchester United in the newspapers after a game or online, and there's a quote from the managers, this is the room that that's been said in. So all the journalists will sit where you're sat here, and on a match day, through this door will come the away team manager first, and we'll take a seat in the middle seat there. And we'll speak for, they normally last about 8 or 9 minutes, the press conference is not too long. And after the away team manager's gone, last season of course Louis van Gaal would come in, take a seat and speak for 3 hours about his philosophy. Next season, Mr. Mourinho of course will come and take a seat there and speak to members of the media. There's a press officer who controls the press conference to make sure everybody's asking sensible questions, etc. And then the managers will disappear through that door. Everyone here will then go through that door at the back. That's where the press lounge is. So that's where the refreshments are. That's where the desks are for the journalists to be able to type their match reports and send their audio back to wherever it needs to go to. But this room's a very famous room as well because there was a period of about 10 years where Manchester United would unveil their latest signings in here. So everyone who signed for the club from 1992 for about 10 years
So we're talking about people like Eric Cantona, Roy Keane, Peter Schmeichel, Teddy Sheringham, Andy Cole, Dwight York. Very, very famous Manchester United players. All the way up to Diego Forlan. Remember him? Yes. Fantastic Uruguayan goal scorer. Just not for us. Although he did score two goals against...
Liverpool.
Well done, yes. So he was an absolute legend. But of course, if you look around this room, there's about 60-odd seats in there. These days, when United sign players, it is massive news. Mm-hmm. When United signed the likes of Di Maria and Falcao, there was 250 journalists that wanted to come to that press conference. We can't fit everyone in here. So we'll either do it now at our training complex, the Aon Training Complex, which is about 5 miles away from here. The press facilities, very similar, but much bigger. Or we'll use one of the suites at Old Trafford, do it there, so obviously then people can have their photographs on the pitch, etc. So this room now really just used on a match day, and that's really what you can say about the stadium. Yes, does anybody have any questions? Very well-behaved journalist, Pete. It's not like this on a match day.
No, obviously would like this, wouldn't he?
He certainly would. Be a bit boring though, I think. As you can see, we've got some cameras ready. We did a little bit of filming a bit later on, guys. So normally the background you would see all the way along, obviously. Okay, guys, if you've no questions, follow me. We're going to the VIP room next door.
Thank you. VIP room, press box. VIP židla to moc nejsou. Hezky to tady voní.
Who knows? The Swedish flag. It's not here just yet. But you never know. He said he was going to do some big news yesterday, didn't he? He said.
He's in Manchester.
He's in Manchester, is he? Have you seen him, have you? Considering Sweden are playing in the Euros, he's probably in the wrong country. Who knows? It's very exciting, wouldn't it? It'd be very exciting. We shall see. It's going to be a very interesting summer. Anyway, guys, where we are now, this is our VIP lounge. So this is where the Manchester United directors, any invited guests, the visiting team directors as well, will spend their time before making their way into the director's box. So in other words, guys, you can't buy a ticket for this area. You have to be invited by the club. So as I said, it's the United directors, very famous Manchester United fans, of course. Usain Bolt, massive fan, he's in here quite a lot. The likes of Rory McIlroy, the golfer, very famous actors, people like that who are Manchester United fans, will often spend their time in here. Everyone has a pre-match meal up there. This used to be where the players ate before the game. They don't do that here anymore, they do it at a local hotel. And through that door there, it's a private room. That's for the owners of the club, the Glazer family when they're here from America, and the Manchester United directors. So that's where people like Sir Alex Ferguson, Sir Bobby Charlton, etc. will spend their time. And then about 5 or 10 minutes before the game, people then tend to wander through to the director's box and we'll take a seat there. We're not going to stop there, we're going to walk in front of it and head down towards the changing rooms. But as we do walk in front of it, you'll see to your left some of the names on the seat, some very, very famous people in the history of Manchester United in the day-to-day running of the club. So if you want to follow me, we're not going to stop, we're just going to walk down and we're going to make our way down to the changing rooms. Okay, this way, guys.
Tomu nemůžu uvěřit, že jsem tady.
Thank you. Okay, do you know where the group leader is?
I hope so.
Yeah, I hope so.
I hope so, yeah.
And what else?
I don't know any secrets, but I hope so.
All right.
It looks that way he's coming in, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It does look that way.
You need someone.
We need an arrogant quality player.
Exactly.
Yeah.
You got Rooney, buddy. You know.
We need that next level ego, you know.
Yeah, cheers.
Yeah. I'm hoping he's coming. I was very excited when he said he was coming.
Yeah. Cheers.
He's a free agent, he can sign any day, can't he?
Exactly. I hope they will do that. It would be just amazing, just massive. Mourinho and him, wow.
Oh, I would be hated again with them.
They will burn it down here. They will fucking burn it down, yeah.
Is coming.
Well, this defender looks like he's coming, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Eric Bailey.
Yeah.
Barley, I hope he knows it. Yeah, hopefully a few more.
And last question, did you like Van Gaal?
Yeah.
I will, sorry.
Yes, when we do, we're going to hit a couple of doors. Those doors, you need to hold on.
Zjistil jsem si tajné informace, tak jsem to musel vypnout. A jdeme do šatén. Cheers. Brownsells tady mají. Hráči si můžou dát, ty vole. Hráči si můžou dát majonézu, vole, před zápasem do píči. Tam musíme dřív než Korejci, nebo se z toho poserem a nevejdem se tam. Se rozhodl, že vás dneska ušetřím 500 selfíček a natočím jedno pořádný video. Cheers. Pěkně onošený dres od Zidána. Nic, tak čekal jsem trošku něco víc. Něco ve stylu stadionu New York Yankees, jejich šaten, nebo něco takového. To je moje ledničku.
Are we united very shortly? You've seen how the two rooms do compare. By the time it might be a room, might be a bad room. You'll find out in a few minutes. Business team in this city, yes. So we United play Arsenal, Liverpool, this room here.
You play the shirts like you see, the Danes play here at Old Trafford. It's got a few who play against United in the Champions League. All in it, all has been. It's got David Beckham in return for AC Milan. Ronaldo for Real Madrid, Barcelona for Messi as well, he won number 19, not the famous number 10 these days. And Real Madrid's Champions League winning manager, there as well. The rest are international neutral games held here in the stadium. Join London 2012 Olympic Games, we play some football games here. Abby Wambach, she played here for the American female team twice, she scored twice. Last year she retired from international football as well as 183 international goals. That's a record for a male or a female player. Big Rudy's just hit on 50 now. Well, yeah, fuck's
it. Tak, jdeme do šatny. Jdeme za Runem. Any sound? Nothing like that?
No sound.
A takhle to vypadá v šatně domácích. A jedem. Ashley Young. Da-da-da. De Gea. Hodně příjemný drezík. Antonio Valencia. S Chris Smalling. Danny Blind. Royal. Carrick. Fellaini. Ten má nejhorší účest celý Premier League. Mata. Podle mě dost předražený. Rooney. Víš, jak to má s těma vlasy. Anthony Marshall. Rashford. Na něj určitě brojko. Budou teďka spolíhat. Memphis Depay. Inga. Tak tady Alexi jeho taktiky před zápasama. Je to skleněná tabule. A to okay. To je právě v kabinetu na základce tady, normálně nekecám, to je v kabinetu na základce. Fakt starý, koukni na to. Máme tady VGA připojení a na starý iPod, to měl asi ještě, nebo ještě za Ronaldo možná. Takže tady se sedí. Tady sedí, když se převlíkají. A je to... Je to kurevsky nepohodlný. Fakt nepohodlný. Mají na lítačky. Přijdou, píchnou a pak zase můžou jít.
So what I'm talking about is all about last season. Starting 11 players, got chained on the back wall here. Starting number one, De Gea, Pointer Rashford 39 just in the corner.
Myslím, že my se asi hádají o zásuvky, vole, kluci, protože tady mají dvě.
Into defenders.
Ale mají další dvě, takže tyhle jsou bez elektriky kluci.
Substitute players, go at the sides. The attacking subs, close to the attacking players. Defensive subs, close to the defensive players. Each of the coaches that way, talk to the players that they're looking after.
To tady velký tak akorát, ale trošičku, nevím, trošičku depresivní.
As the coaches here, next to the tactics boards, easy for them to talk to the players. Looking after joining the team talk. CV in the middle, the show's TV as we would watch it on MUTV or Sky Sports is on a match. They don't see anything different that we would see. They do have a technology, but not the time to set it up at half time. Only 15 minutes, just simply not enough time to set up the TV to show back anything that happened in the first half. On TV, we have an iPod dock. Players can listen to music while Sergei's changed. Now, music traditionally is started. Music officially is controlled by the captain, but Captain Wayne Rooney, he's been banned from playing his own music inside this room.
Rooney mu zakázali, aby tady pouštěl hudbu jako DJ, protože s tím všichni ostatní tak otravoval, že to dostal zákazem.